What's up, guys? Jimmy or Chaos, welcome back. And there's a lot of questions about how supply drop weapons that have attachments already on them are going to affect your pick 13 class. And I want to explain it and clear it up because it can be a little bit confusing. And first thing is, Michael Condry of Sledgehammer tweeted out that the supply drop loot weapons with the variants with locked attachments, they do not count against your pick 13 slots. Now, that doesn't clear everything up for some people because you could go two ways with that. Okay, first thing you could say is, well, does that mean I can get four attachments on a gun? Because that's what it sounds like. They don't go against my pick 13. Therefore, I could get up to three other attachments because I can throw on a primary gunfighter wild card and kind of manipulate the system. That's not true. I know that's the first thing I thought as well. So look on the screen here, and what exactly it means is, and if you didn't know, you can get these weapons through supply drops. They're variant weapons, different camos, different attachments, and the attachment is, it's stuck with that weapon. You can't take it off. You can't do anything with it. For instance, you could get an SN6 professional jury that has a laser sight. You're going to have it. If you use the gun, it is permafixed to that gun. Or you could get a gun and a bow that has an ACOG that you can't do anything about it. It's stuck with the ACOG. And he's telling you that it doesn't go against your pick 13. But if you look at the regular created class system, you'll look at it, it's taking up a slot on your pick 13. As you can see on the screen right here, the laser sight is on the attachment slot for the SN6 Jury Professional version, yet there's a little lock next to it so you can't mess with it. But it doesn't count. If you'll look at the picture, aside from the laser sight, he has 13 things picked on his created class. And then you go to the score streak number 3, the Goliath, and he can't have it because it says he has 14 out of 13. So if you count up all the attachments, he has 13, not counting the laser sight. So it doesn't go against your pick 13, but you are not going to be able to manipulate and have four attachments, barring you get a gun that has an attachment, and then you go try to get two attachments as your normal, and then you throw on your wild card primary gunfighter and try to get another one. You can't do that. The most attachments you can have on a gun is going to be 3. 2 if you have a regular one, and then 1 if it's the extra one if it comes with your supply drop weapon. So I hope that clears it up. It doesn't affect your created class. It doesn't count as a point. It does show up on your created class, but it's not taking away one of your 13 points. It's just there. It's locked, letting you know that that attachment is already on the gun, but you can't manipulate it and rock out four attachments, kind of like we thought may happen with the Honey Badger and Ghost, but it didn't turn out that way. So there you go, guys. Let me know what you think about the supply drops and all the variants, all the information we're getting. It's pretty exciting. I can't wait to see some of these special guns that nobody's seen yet. I bet they've got some really, really cool ones that we're going to be able to get our hands on. So I will see you guys later, and I hope this clears up everything about the variant weapons and their attachments.